3, lost 3, when we've had a memorable weekend for the FA Cup heroes of Tamworth and Chasetown to relive.
And Dan's at Tamworth right now. Dan, I bet there are a few sore heads there tonight, although they look remarkably fit behind you.
Well, that's because it's the youth team, you see. They haven't probably hit the beer yet, Suzanne. But no denying the result of round one. Yes, it was Tamworth's victory at Bournemouth. In a moment, we'll speak to a couple of the men involved. But first of all, let's review that fantastic weekend of FA Cup action and have a look at the non-league winners. Tamworth have hardly set the conference alight this season, so Bournemouth might have expected an easy afternoon. They were wrong. Jake Edwards went galloping clear and Graham Ward followed up for Tamworth to take the lead. They were pegged back by half-time. Brian Stock's free kick was clinical. But Tamworth weren't finished. They pressed and pressed, and Marcus Browning handled in the penalty area while under pressure. Kyle Storer had the tie's fate in his hands. He dispatched the penalty with aplomb to create the upset of round one. Hereford United's cup pedigree is well known, but they had a difficult tie at Cambridge City on Friday night. John Brady's winner was good enough to win any game, though. They host Stockport in round two. Nuneaton are in form and showed Ramsgate no mercy. One mistake allowed Rob Oddie to fire them into the lead. It was his cross which saw David Staff kill the tie off by half-time. And with another home draw against Histon in round two, they have a real chance of making it even further. And of course, a draw is enough to keep you in the hat for round two and keep that dream alive. Now, that's the case for Burton Albion and Worcester City, and of course, Chasetown, who performed fantastically yesterday under the full glare of the television cameras. Ben Sidwell spent the day with the team.
Something we'll all cherish for the rest of our lives. You know, this is still the dream we've been living, and, let's keep it going.
Brilliant, once in a lifetime. Never had it like this before.
It was the biggest day in Chasetown Football Club's history. 2,000 fans packed into their ground to see if the team could pull off one of the biggest FA Cup shocks of all time.
Yes, I think we're going to win. We're going to beat them.
Excited. Never seen anything like this down here before.
I've got to stand and fight.
Despite Chasetown being seven divisions lower than League One side Oldham, they weren't about to let their fans down.
There's Alton's long throw. Well hit through the crowd. Oh, it's gone in as an off day at house. It's Nick Harrison. Chasetown are in front.
Oldham did equalise, but this was Chasetown's day.
Yes, come on!
And the celebrations began at the final whistle.
Brilliant.
More than we ever expected.
Absolutely brilliant. Brilliant. Proud of them.
Second time recorder, so I can watch it over and over again, but as I say, it's a dream.
I cannot comprehend what they've done here, how far they've got. It's a great day. Really, it's a great day.
We're going to win the FA Cup. We're going to Wembley!
I couldn't be any more proud of those lads today. And they've stuck at it, fought their hearts out like lions, and we've got the result. You know, it's just a dream.
So Chasetown's FA Cup run continues, and the players and fans are already preparing for next Wednesday's replay at Oldham.
Sadly, Leamington can't do that, though their dream ended on Saturday with a heavy defeat at Colchester. Kevin Reid went along.
Leamington's day began full of optimism, and with the national press on the bandwagon, this was to be a fairy tale cup tie. But it didn't go to plan, as Colchester were soon in control. In the end, they ran out 9-1 winners, but at least the goal of the game went to the breaks.
The roof had come off if they could just find a goal, and here comes Richard Adams, who might try a shot from distance. Go on, Richard. Oh, what a strike!
For the minute, I touched it. I had a feeling at first it was going over, but it just dips and hit the back of the net, and I just hit an all-time high in my football. That was an absolute moment for me, despite the fact that we was already seven goals down. That was a real moment for me. And it's one I'll savour. Enjoy and hopefully see on match of the day.
Real love, In the end, defeat was inevitable, but at least followed by a glorious ovation.
I'm proud of what they've achieved, but it was emotional, and I thought the supporters gave us a big lift at the end. They're absolutely tremendous supporters.
So Leamington's dream finally came to an end, but not before a huge boost to their finances and a wonderful day in the club's history.
And let's face it, they did fantastically to get that far. Let's get back to Tamworth. Carl Storer, scorer from Saturday. He scored the penalty, the winning goal. Talk us through it.
Well, we've been taking stick all week in training. Basically, the gaffer said, here's the ball, take the penalty, stuck it down. And just delighted to see the keeper parry it into my path and put it away. I was on my toes, put it away.
So you were told to go and attack the ball?
Yeah, basically, yeah. So, you know, I made up for my early mistake in the first half and I gave the free kick away. Their equaliser, but just really glad to see it going in the second round.
Mark Cooper's the manager here. Mark, difficult draw away at Hartlepool. What do you make of that?
Yeah, tough draw, could have been easier, but we said that when we got drawn against Bournemouth. You know, that was a tough draw. Obviously, Hartlepool are in the same position, in the same league, so, you know, it's one of them things. If we're on the top of our game and they're not quite right, we get a chance of going into the big, you know, into the third round.
Obviously takes the pressure off the league situation. Nice bit of revenue as well, because you're part-time here. A lot of conference sides have got full-time squads.
Yeah, I think there's only a couple of us left in a conference part-time, and we're one of them, and it's getting increasingly difficult to compete. So obviously a bit, you know, more revenue we get in, the better, and enable us to stay in the conference, hopefully.
Has it relieved a bit of pressure? Because you said you've got a few tough games coming up in the conference next few weeks between the two FA Cup ties.
Yeah, we've got three or four teams down around by us to play in the conference, starting with Scarborough at home on Saturday, who are below us. And you know, it's a welcome relief from the league. Takes the pressure off the lads. There's no pressure on them to, you know, that they have to win, especially at Bournemouth Saturday. There was no pressure and we went out and played really well.
And who knows, well, you might draw if you could get a result there. But one other piece of football news today, and the assistant manager at Stoke City, Yander Cooning, and the director of football, John Rudge, have been given 7 days off following a disagreement with the manager, Johan Boskamp. Now, the fallout apparently happened last week in the match against Coventry City, and neither are on duty for Saturday's victory against Brighton. So strange goings on at Stoke City, but they're all smiles here at Tamworth. They've got a great tie to look forward to. Let's face it, in the FA Cup, they're already winners this season.
Too, right.
Thanks, Dan. Congratulations to Tamworth and all the others who got
My
through.
My favourite.